Here with Kathy Engelbert. And how did the events of today unfold where you had to make this difficult decision?
Yeah, so Holly, as you know, player health and safety and staff health and safety were number one when we were planning this back in May into June, and number one today now that we're in the semifinals. So, you know, we've got some tests back for the Seattle team, and they were inconclusive. So we, you know, really, when there's, especially if there's multiple players on a team, we really can't take a chance to expose the bubble to any kind of community spread. We need to see, get more data, get more testing, and get more data to see whether we have an issue or not. And so we decided to postpone the game.
I know that, you know, Minnesota was here warming up. I assume that Seattle was probably on their way. How did you communicate this in a quick fashion?
So I was back at the hotel right as Seattle was boarding the bus, actually, when we got the information. And so, you know, I went on the bus, actually talked to the players on the bus about, you know, what was happening. It was real time, that we needed more testing and more data. And so as soon as I talked to them, it was clear they were, you know, obviously concerned. We're all concerned about health and safety while we're here. And it wasn't about basketball at that point. It was around doing the right thing. And we decided, after talking with the players, talking with some other league officials, talking with some of our medical safety, player health and safety, that this was the right thing to do. So we could just have another day or two to get more testing back.
I know that this is, you know, inconclusive doesn't mean positive, but what kind of thought, or have you even allowed your mind to go there, of how this could, this trickle-down effect could affect us moving forward?
Yeah, this is the hardest part of COVID-19 and putting on live sports during it, is every day you're reset to zero. So the fact that we might have had 70 negatives before this doesn't actually matter. It's about keeping the bubble safe. You know, making sure that there's no community spread, because the purpose of the testing program and the protocols we have is to actually be able to pull anybody out who is positive COVID before they're infectious. So that is the main thing we're trying to do here, is make sure we have all the data, all the testing, so that if someone is infected with COVID, we can get them into isolation, take care of them, their safety, and then move on with play. So I don't expect it to, you know, hopefully we'll get good data over the next 24 to 48 hours and be back on the court with those two teams on with game one on Tuesday. But, you know, we've got to continually assess the testing. So the whole team will obviously has already been tested today. We'll test them tonight, and then we'll test, you know, we're doing additional testing on those players that had these inconclusive results.
How critical was it for you to make this decision, knowing that it's hard, but that you have to be absolutely right about this?
Yeah, you have to be right. You have to put the data, the science first. And while we would have liked to had a game right now on ABC, because we're in the WNBA semifinals with four teams left, you have to follow your gut, you have to follow your instinct, and you have to follow the data and the science. And so far, everything has worked in the bubble because we followed the science. And while it's been hard because we had previous players miss games during the regular season because we were following the science, and, you know, the virus is so unpredictable that it takes time to run these tests and then to get those results and to evaluate them then for purposes of returning a player to play or a coach or a trainer. So we've dealt with several of these, and again, this was the right thing to do today.
Okay, well, we hope that we will see you back here on Tuesday. Thank you so much, and thank you for your transparency. This is a fluid, crazy situation, and we appreciate you being here and being willing to discuss it in detail.
Yeah, thanks, Holly, and thanks, Holly. Holly knows more than anyone that being in the bubble every day is a new day.
Absolutely. Thank you so much.